हेलो डियर स्टूडेंट्स, अ वेरी गुड मॉर्निंग टू ऑल ऑफ यू. डियर चिल्ड्रन, इन आवर टुडेज़ वीडियो वी विल डिस्कस द रिलेशनशिप बिटवीन डायपोल मोमेंट वैल्यू एंड मॉलिकुलर ज्योमेट्री और वी कैन से मॉलिकुलर स्ट्रक्चर. ओके, सो एक्चुअली व्हाट हैपेंस दैट इन अ मॉलिक्यूल बॉन्ड्स कैन बी प्रेजेंट इन डिफरेंट डिफरेंट डायरेक्शन. लाइक इफ वी टॉक अबाउट CO2, सो CO2 इज प्रेजेंट लाइक दिस. ओके, इन BF3 बोरॉन एंड 3 फ्लोरिन एटम एग्जिस्ट लाइक दिस. ओके, इन अमोनिया ऑल द एटम्स प्रेजेंट लाइक दिस. ओके, दिस इज अ लोन पेयर ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन एंड दीज आर 3 हाइड्रोजन एटम प्रेजेंट इन अमोनिया. ओके, सिमिलरली इन कार्बन एटम हाइड्रोजन्स आर प्रेजेंट लाइक दिस, टेट्राहेड्रल फॉर्म. ओके, सो दिस इज टेट्राहेड्रल ज्योमेट्री, दिस इज पिरामिडल ज्योमेट्री, दिस इज ट्राइगोनल प्लेनर ज्योमेट्री, दिस इज लीनियर ज्योमेट्री. So you can see here that in different molecular structures, bonds can be present in different positions. So in this way, we can say that molecules have different geometries. Okay. Now suppose we want to calculate the dipole moment for this molecule or this molecule. Okay. So in these molecules, what we have to do, we have to consider all the bond dipole. Okay. Suppose we want to calculate the net dipole moment for this molecule. Okay, so if we want to calculate mu net, so we have to consider all the bond dipole present in this molecule. As I told you that mu means dipole moment is a vector quantity. Okay, so to calculate the mu net, we have to do the vectorial addition. So vectorial addition means when we do vectorial addition in this molecule or in this molecule, we have to consider the magnitude as well as direction also. Okay, so as we are considering here direction as well, so we can say that dipole moment depends upon the geometry also. Okay, so oppositely, in a way, we can also say that if we have the value of net dipole moment for a molecule, we can have an idea about the geometry of that particular molecule. Okay, I told you how. Okay, let's discuss diatomic molecule first. Diatomic molecule. So diatomic molecule can be of two type. Okay, like A2 or AB. A2 means O2, Cl2, Br2, F2, I2, means in which both the surrounding atoms are same. Okay, they are also known as homoatomic molecules. So in homoatomic molecule, as you can see that both the atoms are same, like in F2, both the surrounding atoms are same. So definitely they will have the same electronegativity. So the shared pair of electron will remain in between these two atoms. Okay, so no polarity will be there. Okay, so no need to calculate the dipole moment for such type of molecule. Okay, homoatomic molecule. Now let's talk about the hetero. So heteroatomic molecule like HCl, HBr, HI, HF. Okay, so these are AB type of molecule, means in which both the surrounding atoms are different. So in these molecules, as both the atoms are different, so definitely they will have different electronegativity. Okay, as in HCl, chlorine is more electronegative, so definitely the shared pair of electron will shift towards the chlorine atom, and there will be a certain negative charge and here positive charge. So polarity should be there. Okay, so in such type of molecule, in order to calculate the dipole moment, what we will do, we will just consider the bond dipole as a dipole moment. Okay, what is bond dipole? Bond dipole is actually the dipole moment of a single or a particular covalent bond. Okay, as in this molecule, it has some dipole, bond dipole, and bond dipole. And in order to calculate the mu net, what we will do? We will do the vectorial addition of all bond dipoles. Okay. So as here only one bond is present, so we will not do the vectorial addition here. Okay. So in this case, we can say that bond dipole is equals to the dipole moment in this molecule. Okay. And one more thing. In this molecule, we can say that more the electronegativity difference between these two surrounding atoms, more will be the bond dipole, and hence more will be the dipole moment. Okay. So for diatomic molecule, we can calculate the dipole moment, net dipole moment, like this, okay, which will equal to the bond dipole itself. Now let's talk about the another molecule, triatomic. So first of all, you should know that triatomic molecules means I am talking about AB2. Okay. So in AB2 types of molecule, they can be of two type. They can have two types of geometry. Okay. Like they can be linear or bent. Okay. So as I told you here that on the basis of value of dipole moment, we can have an idea about the geometry of the molecule. Okay, let's see how. Suppose we are talking about CO2. Okay, so for CO2 molecule, actually mu net is equals to zero. So if mu net equals to zero, it suggests that in CO2 molecule, geometry should be like both the dipole, bond dipole will cancel each other. Okay, like this. So what happens in this molecule, in this geometry? In this geometry, as you can see here, that this is more electronegative and this is less electronegative, or we can say this is positive end and this is negative end. So definitely dipole moment will be in this direction, and oppositely here in this direction. So as surrounding atoms are same, electronegativity of surrounding atoms are same, electronegativity of central atom, electronegativity difference of central atom and surrounding atoms are same here and here. Okay, so definitely the bond dipole the bond dipole which creates here will be equals to the bond dipole here. Okay, and as they are opposite, equal and opposite, so when we do the vectorial addition, both these value will cancel out each other. So in this way, mu net we will found equals to zero. So here we can say that if mu net equals to zero for a particular molecule, which is triatomic molecule, then the geometry should be linear. Okay, like in BeCl2 also mu equals to zero, so that's why Be, the geometry of Be is like this. Okay, again for BeF2 mu equals to zero, so for this molecule also geometry is like this. So the value of mu net zero for triatomic molecule suggests the linear geometry. Okay, now let's talk about the bent. So actually for water molecule, mu is not equals to zero. Okay, the value of mu is equals to around 1.85 d. okay, I am talking about the mu net. Okay, so here the value which is not equals to zero suggests that the geometry of H2O should not be like CO2 molecule. Okay, as we are having some value of dipole moment, so other option is bent structure. So in H2O molecule, both the atoms are present like this. Okay, bent. This is linear and this is bent geometry. So in this geometry, what happens? In this geometry, you can see that the dipole moment will be in this direction, from positive to negative, and here again positive to negative. So when we do the vectorial addition here, the resultant dipole moment will be in upward direction. So in this way, we will have some value of mu naught here. So this is why triatomic molecule having a definite value of mu will be of this geometry. Now this is about the triatomic molecule. Now let's talk about the tetraatomic molecule. So like triatomic molecule, tetraatomic molecule also may or may not have the definite value of dipole moment depending upon their geometry. Okay, so first of all, what is tetraatomic molecule? AB3 type of molecule. Okay, 1 and 3 means 4. 4 atoms are present in this, that's why tetraatomic molecule. Okay, now let's take the example of NH3 and BF3. So you can see here that both the molecules are tetraatomic. Okay, BF3 and NH3 also, but in these cases actually mu net for BF3 is equals to 0, and here mu net is not equals to 0 for ammonia. So the value of mu not, which is equals to 0 for BF3, suggest that the geometry of this molecule should be like this. This is trigonal planar geometry. Okay, so in this geometry, what happens? In this geometry, you can see here that dipole moment will be here in this direction, here in this direction, and here in this direction. So when we will do vectorial addition for these two bond, then the resultant dipole moment will be in this direction. Okay, which cancel out this bond dipole. Okay, so in this way we will have mu net equals to 0 here. So here the value of mu net, which is equals to 0, suggest that BF3, the geometry of BF3 should be this type, this trigonal pyramidal type, trigonal planar type. Okay, now let's talk about the ammonia. So in ammonia actually you can see that mu net is not equals to 0. Okay, so as it is not equals to 0, it suggests that the geometry of NH3 should not be like this. Okay, so in NH3 what happens? In NH3 actually the three surrounding hydrogen atoms are present like this, and the bond pair, the lone pair is present like this. Okay, so this is called pyramidal geometry. Okay, so in this geometry what happens? In this geometry dipole moment will be in this direction, here in this direction, and here in this direction. So when we will do the vectorial addition in this molecule, we will found the resultant dipole moment in upward direction. Okay, from a nitrogen atom to lone pair of electron. So in this way we will definitely have a certain value of dipole moment which is not equals to 0. So in this way, on the basis of the value of mu net, we can have an idea about the geometry, as it should be trigonal planar, it should be pyramidal. Okay, so in this way we can have an idea on the basis of the value of dipole moment. Okay, so one more thing is that you must have noticed that it is not necessary that a molecule which has polar bond should have a certain value of dipole moment. As you can see here that in BF3 all the bonds are polar, but the net dipole moment for this molecule is equals to 0. Okay, and CO2 also, for CO2 molecule also this is a polar bond, this is again a polar bond, but the net dipole for this molecule is equals to 0. So you have to remember these things about the geometry I am telling. Okay, I hope all the examples are clear to you. Thank you.